In this video, we're going to look at how to change the working days that occur during your project. So first of all, let's look at the default of how project is set up if you don't do anything. So what you'll notice on the Gantt chart form is that there's certain days of the week that are sort of grayed, and there's certain ones that are white. The grayed ones are non-working days, and you can see that they're weekends, Saturday and Sunday. So the default in MS Project is a 5-day work week, 8 hours a day, 40 hours a week. And those can all be changed. There's options and so on. But generally, for most projects, that seems to suffice. If you click on under Project, Change Working Time, it brings up the dialog box that you need to look at. Now, first of all, there some of the more advanced features is that there are different calendars that you can associate with your project. We are using the standard now, which I just described, but there is a 24-hour calendar. There is a night shift calendar, and you can have calendars for specific people as well. But that's beyond the scope of what we want to look at. We're just going to look at the usual types of things. So the typical, as mentioned, it's a 5-day work week, 8 hours per day. And it even describes the hours worked. A lot of projects don't really worry about, schedules don't really worry about the hours, but it's there if you need to. So let's look at two things. One is, let's say that we would like to, step one, we would like to define Saturday as a working day. So in effect, a 6-day work week. So in that case, we click on work weeks here, click there, and then click on details. And then this is where you're going to indicate what's different from the standard. So we will say that we want Saturday to be a work day, and we just need to give it the times. So we'll do that just to be consistent with how everything else is done, and we'll just keep it the same as the others and the other days. So 5 p.m. That's an 8-hour work day. So we've made Saturday as a work day. We press OK, and we press OK. Now watch what's going to happen to, if you can watch behind here as I press OK. You'll notice that the schedule shifted in because of all the automatic dependencies. We're now able to, and this should be apparent, we're now able to complete the project sooner. So because we only have, we're working 6 days a week, so these durations of the activities can be done quicker. So that's one option you have. I'm just going to undo that, switch it back. Notice the schedule reverted back to now we have a 5-day work week. And let's say, for example, we want to, Monday, April 6th is a statutory holiday for this case. So we don't want to schedule people to work on that day. So we can change specific days. Now, first of all, we need to move ourselves to that month. So we'll go to there. We click on the day itself. And now what we'll say is this is a stat holiday. And it goes to the day that we selected there. And it's an exception. So because it's a work day previously, it'll make it a non-working day if we press OK. So we'll do that. And notice what happened here is that Monday is now gray. We're not scheduling work in it, and it bumped out our schedule essentially by a day. So that's the way, using those two tools. One is to affect a whole day consistently for your project, and the other is you can affect certain days for your project. We'll see you next time.